sit silently and be aware. And if the vibrations are not coming up, just visualize my hand is on your head, and then the vibration energy will start. So this will actually purify your vasanas. It'll reduce your vasanas. Vasanas is because the direction of energy flow is downwards. It should be upwards.
There's a struggle between the awareness of that and the awareness of the pulling down of.
Yes. Yeah, but then don't have to, you just focus on that center. So that'll start pulling, it'll become, it'll generate momentum. Okay. And you have to have understanding that I am Shakti, I am becoming one is Shiva. Everybody's clear?
Should we sit in a certain mudra or not necessary?
If you are comfortable, you sit in there. There's no, see this is actually more of a sort of a, what you call as, Shaktipat. Okay, here everything else is just a.
This is the focus more on the consciousness there.
Yeah, but the mudras help you too.
Yeah, yeah, that's. Whatever is comfortable, you do it. Right? So we go next. So you had a question the last class, right? What was the question?
Not a punishment.
Yeah. I'll tell you why karma is not a punishment, okay? So first you have to understand games and spirituality. Karma is a punishment. Right? So the life is a divine game, divine play. Okay? When we say divine play, life is not there to God is somewhere, some like a, what you call as a, that fellow, no? Who feels happy, torturing people.
Sadist.
He's not a sadist. Okay? So it is not intention that you suffer in life. That's not the intention. It is a game. So that's why our ancestors said life is a game. It's called Leela, play. Okay? The life is a game. It's called Leela, play. I put it in a other way. Life is a divine drama. Life is a divine drama. If you don't understand it, it becomes horrible trauma. Okay. So what happens is that if it's not, don't understand it's a divine game, divine play, you start taking everything very seriously. Life, nothing is to be taken seriously. You have to have a commitment. You have to have a purpose. But life is not serious. Okay. So that you have to understand. And that was taught to our children at the young age of 4 years by our old ancestors. They taught children at the age of 4, the divine play. Okay? So I wanted to add one more. Okay, I'll add that. I'll just show you.
You discussed this last time.
No, this is because I want to, another setting. Right? So Okay. So, the life what we experience is a divine drama. Okay. Now, if you don't understand this, life will become a big drama. In divine drama, people appear, they play their role and disappear. Appear, disappear. You start making it very serious, then you're in trouble. So our ancestors told in different ways that divine drama is all about. You heard of this Narada and Vishnu? Okay. So the divine drama is called Maya. Here one day Narada tells Vishnu, okay, what is Maya all about? I don't know. I am so close to you and I am unaffected by Maya because I am Brahmachari. Okay, I am very close to you, so I don't get affected by Maya. Vishnu says, fine. And one day they were going for a walking near the seashore. Vishnu says, I'm thirsty, can you get me one glass of water? So Narada runs to the nearby village and knocks a door. A most beautiful girl opens the door. So Narada forgets glass of water. He falls at her feet and says, will you marry me? Okay, she says, yes. Provide one condition. You have to take care of household, you have to do work. Okay. You have to earn money, enough money for our family. So Narada says, yes. Narada has forgotten Vishnu, Narada has forgotten Vaikuntha, Narada has forgotten Maya. Now he has a agricultural land. Yes, he is doing the everyday tilling and earning money. Okay. And they have 6 children also. And these children, one day there is a flood in the city, the heavy rains, many years are gone. Heavy rains are there and the whole city is washed out. Narada's children are gone, family is gone. Narada starts crying, oh, what happened to my family and all. Then suddenly sees Vishnu standing, what happened to my glass of water? Okay. So, the consciousness creates this like this. There is no time, there is no space. Okay, everything appears as time and space and living beings and disappears. Your life is momentary. How long is your life? How long you live?
Till death.
How is that till death? When is the death? What you don't realize is that every moment the body is dying and coming up.
But we are living.
Who is we are living? The body,
we are all living.
The body is on and off. On and off, like a bulb. When the breath goes in, it's on. When the breath goes out, it's off. After 60 or 70 years, the bulb fuses. But that is no different. The bulb fuses. So the on and off, birth and death is happening moment to moment. Okay, we traditionally say that after 60 years or 70 years the person dies. That's a fusing of the bulb. But the birth and death is moment to moment. Tuck, tuck, tuck. So for us, the concept is birth happens and death happens. It's not like that. Birth and death are simultaneous. As the birth happens, death has started. It's like they are actually coming together. Okay, the moment you start breathing your first breath, already 500,000 cells of your body start dying. Okay, another 500,000 cells get generated. Birth and death is continuously happening. Our mind can only think of one point of birth and one point of death. It's not like that. Birth and death is continuously happening. But I am the consciousness which is not born, not dying, which is watching this. That's why you feel alive. This is alive, you say, not because of this is alive. Because you are watching it, it's alive. The consciousness is giving aliveness to that. Okay, you are the witness who is giving life to the body. The body is coming, going, upping, disappearing, upping, disappearing. Right? So the time appears, space appears. That happened, that you have example of this in dream. In dream, suddenly you go to Paris. Paris appeared, London appeared. Okay, you went to Eiffel Tower, took a selfie, came back also. There's no Paris, there's no London. Okay. Similarly, there's no you, there's no me, there's only consciousness, Narayana, appearing and disappearing. Why are you making this whole thing as a serious business? One thing you have to make is you have to understand it's a movie. Try to get out of the movie and watch the movie rather than getting very seriously involved in that. That's all life. That's the purpose of life. Otherwise, you get trapped in that and life becomes a trauma. So, this is also showed by a Parvati and Shiva playing dice. You have heard of this? Pagade.
Pagade.
Shiva and Parvati play Pagade. So, you think Shiva and Parvati are playing Pagade and Kailas is sitting at this thing? This is the Pagade, the game of you and I are pawns in that appearing and disappearing. Suddenly she decides some six, one person disappears, okay, gone. Okay, so Pagade is not played in Kailasa, this is Pagade, this is the game. She plays some dice, some character appears, okay. So this our ancestors told in the form of game called snake. Chaturanga. Snake and ladder. This is called Mokshapata. The game was called Mokshapata. So Mokshapata had seven layers. This is level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. They are called Bhuloka, Bhuvarloka, Suvarloka, Maharloka, Janaloka, Tapoloka. Various lokas. None of the lokas are constant. The purpose of the game is to go reach Moksha, the liberation. Okay, so here each step by step you go is karma, and here if you go, you do sadhana or grace. So the biggest sadhana or grace will happen when first host to you jump to the last. That can happen only through atma vichara or self knowledge. Rest are all other spiritual paths, and you go some steps and fall back because of the vasanas, impressions. Okay, so that was the game of Mokshapata. It's called, also it's called Paramapada. The game was called Paramapada, Supreme Reality. Supreme Reality is I. The purpose is to understand I. The purpose is to understand I. I am the divine child. That's all is the purpose. So in that purpose, you do a lot of circus. Go there, do some breathing practice, go to Yatra, go back and, oh, after going to Yatra also, I am like this only. Oh, after that, I did so much of spiritual asana, I am like this only. They are all vasanas. Okay, only Jnana can free you, Atma Vichara can free you. Atma Vichara is the direct path. It takes you to the last step.
Paramapada.
So you have heard of this game called hide and seek? Right? You know what is hide and seek? So there is in that game, there is one person called Ajji. 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 Okay, Ajji will close the eyes. Right, and other people will run and hide. So this person will go and try to touch them. They will touch the out. So they come and touch Ajji, they'll be
free.
Right.
Free.
So that day I said earlier, they gave this song. Kanna muche kade gude uddina mute urle hoito namma haki nimma haki hari hoito.
Namma ki bitte wo nimma ki muche
ko. Oh, nimma muche. So. What the game is, Ajji, Ajji means wise woman, Jnani. Okay, it's also actually Jagannmate, mother, universal mother. She will close the eyes. Okay, so then everybody is running around. Who is hiding and who is seeking? The Atma, Paramatma himself is hiding and he is seeking. Each of you is Shiva, Shiva only. Okay, Shiva is hiding and Shiva is seeking. It is not Jiva seeking Shiva. Shiva is hiding and Shiva is seeking. Shiva is hiding in the form of body. Shivane Jiva, Jivane Shiva. Now you are seeking. Okay. Kade Gude. is lost in the forest. This world you are lost. You are thinking that you are the body, mind and intellect. You are lost. And if this guy touches them, they are out. They come and touch Ajji.
Free.
You understand? This is called realization. And this education was done for the children. There are many games like that, okay? Many games by which they taught spirituality to children, very young age. So, the life is a game of hide and seek. Who is hiding? Paramatma. Who is seeking? Jivatma, but Paramatma. Jivatma only, Paramatma, same Paramatma. Seeking? Yes, sir. Then once you touch the Ajji, or the wise woman, or the Jagan Mata, you'll be free. So that is actually Atmadhyana. Okay? So life is a game. In the game of life, there are certain rules. Right? Without rule, there cannot be game, no? So the cricket, there is some rule.
Yeah.
Kandamuche, there are some rules. Right? If you violate the rules, you cannot play the game.
Out of the game.
Okay, the rules of the game called life is called karma. There are certain rules in the life game called life. And the rules are karma. The rules are not there to punish you. The rules are there for helping you to play the game properly. Okay, let us understand the rules. Karma is not a punishment, okay? Karma is actually the rules of game called life. If you don't follow the rules, there is no game. Right? No, dharma is order. Dharma is order. Karma is the game, rules of the game. Right? So dharma is the order. There is some order in that. That's a different aspect. So karma is a rule. Karma is the game. Okay? Karma is the rules of the game. Now there is a plus point and minus point also. Games. Right? In a game, you have positive points and negative points. Right? So in game called life, the karma has a positive point and negative point. That's called papa and punya. Okay? So what is papa punya? You do something good to others, you'll get some plus points. If you do something negative to others, you'll get some minus points. Okay? Now only this thing is, this plus point and minus point don't cancel each other. It's not like I got 5 plus points and 5 minus points, I'll make it 0 points. No. 5 points, 5 plus points, minus points, you have to experience it. Why you have to experience it is?
Minus.
Okay.
Minus point is experience.
Both you have to experience. Yeah, plus point you experience, you know, you have a body, mind, working organs, everything is working fine now. So, good point, plus point and minus point you have to experience. That's called good karma,
bad karma.
It's not bad karma. Papa Punya, whatever is that. So now why Papa Punya has to experience is, what I do to you, what I do to anybody, I have to experience back. Why I have to experience back? Because you, there's no other you. Shiva only is doing something to Shiva. Now then he has to experience it back.
Understood?
If you hit yourself, you'll feel the pain. Right? If you hit others, you don't feel the pain. That's what you think. But if you hurt others, you also feel the pain because he is also Shiva, you are also Shiva. That effect of that will come back to you. That's called karma. Is it clear? So, now, this is not a punishment. Why? This is a way of learning. Okay, you have to learn that there is no other. If you hate others, the hatred will come back to you because you are hating yourself. If you love others, the love will come back to you because you are loving yourself. The self only. There's no other. For example, okay, in your dream, okay, you met a person and hit him. Right? So now, was there another person? It is you only appearing as other person. Till you learn that I only am everybody, you have to go through this game. The moment you realize that I only are manifesting as everything and everybody, Shiva alone is there, the game is over. And till that learning is not happening, there are rules. Now, these rules you want to call as punishment?
No.
Yes, Suma? For sure?
Only 6 balls, though, is punishment.
Any questions are clearer? So, the karma is not a punishment. Karma is a game designed for you to learn what you do to others will come back to you. Because there's no other. It's only you only. You hate a person, hatred will come back to you. And whoever has come in your life have come, oh, I have a bad husband, I have a bad wife, I have a bad relationship. They have come as a part of the penalty corner. You know, this is penalty corner. You have not learned the lesson. Okay, play it again. Until you learn the lesson, it's repetition.
Excuse
me, this one 6359,
Mahindra scooty.
Who's 6359, anybody has a scooty?
Mahindra scooty. Red color.
Nobody. Scooty, Lindilala. 6359.
6359.
Linda?
Steve Mahina.
Huh?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. Again, block.
It's not in the basement of someone's parking.
It is like below 7 to 1 to only.
Ah, no. Then you have to park in the visitor's lot.
Okay, but he told me to. I can park.
Okay, now he's. I think it's. Somebody else's car is blocking it. Somebody's vehicle.
No, I'm not blocked any car.
No, the security is calling.
So anyway, check it in.
Check it and come. So if there's a thing, you can block or park in the visitor's lot. Basement. So the karma is not a punishment. It's a mechanism for you to learn your divine nature.
Then if we get back hatred, then we have to realize that maybe I have hated someone, so I'm getting it.
Love it. So slowly learning will happen. Slowly. Love begets love, hatred begets hatred, jealousy begets jealousy, anger begets anger.
Is it like rule that you will get hated?
Yes, yes. 100%. Because you are hitting yourself. It will come in different forms. That's called karma. Are you clear?
How to stay in this understanding, like you said, everyone?
No, first you have to, don't worry about everyone. Recognize your divine self. As you start recognizing divine self, gradually start recognizing divine self in everybody. Okay? So, this there, namaste is there, right? The ancient Indian system of namaste means what? The consciousness in me and consciousness in you are one. I am not doing namaste to the body. I am doing namaste to the consciousness, connecting consciousness. Very simple, sir. There is a feeling of I amness in you. Is there I amness in her? One. Do you say I? She says I. They are referring to one I only. Not complex. You are making complicated because you are mixing up with the society child. That's all. The moment you stop mixing with society child and human child, everything is simple. The divine child in you is I am. The divine child in her is I am. The divine child in her is I am. Are they different? I am is different. Okay, I am body is different because you are connected with the human child. I am happy is different because I am connected with society child. I am is the divine child. I am in the divine child, her. as the elephant, ant is same. Now that I am is referring to I, which is pure consciousness. Father, you are also calling I, she is also calling I, everybody is saying I. That I never changes. So then where is the duality? The duality is coming only because you are confusing the society child, that's all, and human child. Until you learn the lesson that all I am and I is only one, you go through cycle of karma, the penalty points, plus points, minus points, you keep learning, earning. It's not a punishment, it's a tool for learning. Any questions? Anybody? Yes, sir.
Yesterday, the anniversary of Jallianwala.
Mm-hmm.
100
years.
Yeah.
100
years.
Mm-hmm. So, I was reading about
that. General Dyer.
Ordered that.
Yeah. Shooting. Yeah.
Within 7 years, he died a very painful death.
What happened to him? Cancer?
Had his body paralyzed. He had multiple strokes. And he died of a brain hemorrhage.
So many things will happen. Okay, it is very simple. The law is very simple. If you hit yourself, you feel the pain. But if you hit others, you don't feel the pain. Okay, because you think it's others. There are no others. The pain will come back to you. It will take some time. That's all. That's karma. Because there are no others. Understand? The I in you, the I in me, the I in him is same. The society child is different, the human child is different. But don't confuse the society child, human child, with the divine child. Divine child is same. Any clear? Any questions?
Karma is what you have done in your past, right?
Now also. Karma has four types. Okay? So there are four types of karma. You missed the last class? Right? So there is no karma. That was the class. How to get rid of karma was the class. Now you are going to minus one step. Okay, there is no karma. We can get out of karma by understanding the nature of karma. That was the class last week. Say one class if you miss.
No, actually I came from Canada.
Oh, you got that Canada?
Reason,
no, the Canada that who is not, I am not the doer, you got it? Oh, the, I'm not the doer. Did you get it? Huh? You didn't get it?
Prabhuji, in the last class also the same snake and ladder game, same hide and seek game.
Yeah.
Video.
No. I'm not the doer.
Yes.
Huh?
Who is making the coffee? Right? Who is making coffee?
Okay. First, then anyway, I'll answer your question of the types of karma.
We have done in Vivekananda class. Coffee
came for two Canada
classes. Because I couldn't attend. No, that making coffee video. Making coffee video in Vivekananda class. Okay. Okay. After the class, I'll show you some video. Okay. So there are four types of karma. Sanchita karma. You got it? It's okay?
Yeah.
Sanchita karma, prarabdha karma, agami and kriyavana. There are four types of karma. Sanchita means accumulated karma. Every lifetime you accumulate. Okay. So there are four types of karma called agami, sanchita means accumulation, okay, and prarabdha means what you have brought the body this time, this body, kriyamana means what you are doing now, aga means what comes in future, okay. So sanchita means many lifetimes you have done something, each lifetime what you have done will become a karma. So in the language of Buddha, he gave example of Sanchita Karma. I have had many, many lifetimes, and I suffered in many lifetimes, and tears of my suffering, if I had accumulated many lifetimes, they'll become an ocean, they'll become a river Ganga, and my backbones, if I pile, they'll become mountain Himalayas. That means lifetimes we have, and every lifetime we commit karma, so that will become what you call Sanchita Karma. It's an accumulation. Now Sanchita Karma is very large, it's called infinite almost. So from Sanchita Karma, we borrow some karma to take this body. Some good karma and bad karma, mixture. It's called Prarabdha Karma. So this body has come out of Prarabdha Karma. Okay. To give an example, this is your bank account. In this bank account, you have, let us say, 10,000 crores. Okay, a huge amount of money. And this lifetime you need only 5 lakhs. So you have taken 5 lakhs and taken this body. This body has come out of Prarabdha Karma, 5 lakhs. So now in this you start doing action, right? And you are a good businessman or woman. Every 5 lakh day, 5 lakh you rotate and make 10 lakhs every day. That becomes a karma which goes to accumulation. Okay. What is karma? A reaction to any a situation, mental reaction becomes the karmic impression. So that gets accumulated agami karma or future karma, which will go into Sanchita Karma again. This cycle will keep on going. Okay. So now you can give it as illustration. This on his back, the arrow, that's called Sanchita Karma. Okay, some arrows he has used, that's called Prarabdha Karma. Okay. So now these arrows which have gone out are called Prarabdha Karma. Enlightenment cannot solve the Prarabdha Karma problem. That means if you get Jnana, you cannot solve it because already its karma has started giving the fruits. Why the body is there? Prarabdha Karma has already started. It can't stop. Okay. It continues. After you get Atmadjnana, what is Atmadjnana? I am pure conscious Shiva Swarupi. The future karma will be blocked. What is called? Agami karma will be blocked. Future karma cannot happen. And Sanchita karma will disappear. That means future lives will stop. Infinite Sanchita karma will get burnt. Okay? But Prarabdha karma will continue because it's already in action. Okay? So the Prarabdha continues only because of that a Jnani like Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Ramana Maharshi, after Jnana also their body continues and they go through cancer and pain because the Prarabdha Karma is fructifying. Okay, why Jnani has a pain? It's Prarabdha Karma. So it's fructifying. But future life will stop. The Sanchita Karma will be burnt. Agami Karma will stop. Okay? Sanchita Karma also doesn't get burnt, it gets redistributed. Okay, the redistribution is saying is that okay, if a person gets enlightened, his good karma will go to his disciples, his santati, and his bad karma will go to people who block, who were creating troubles for his path of spiritual journey. It gets distributed in equal proportion. Okay, funny, for him it is gone, right? But the karma, the moment you understand who is the doer, the karma doesn't affect you, stops, because you are not the doer, the totality is doing. So once you start understanding, I am the doer concept stops. The karma is not because what you do, the karma is because your notion that I am doing. You have a concept that I am the doer. That concept is causing karma. Actually, the karma is happening as a part of the totality. You are an instrumental doer, not an independent doer. Right? So this I will show you a video after the class is over.
End. Karma means life is end.
Karma means?
Life. life end.
Alala, enna life end adhe?
Life is end.
No karma means life ends.
No karma means mukti. Life will not end. The body will continue. Body will continue because body is already karma, prarabdha karma started. After the body dies, there is no birth. Okay? So, the karma, those who understand the real secret of karma, they will be freed from karma. The real secret of karma is there is no independent doer. There is no individual doer. If this understanding very clearly and deeply goes into you, you'll be freed from karma. That's called neshkarmya, non-doership.
So it's like saying all that 1,000 crores in the bank are not money in the government.
It was never my mind. So it was never mine actually. So I'll give my notional right on that. So let us go to Darpana Prakriya. Have I done this?
No.
So let us imagine a situation where, okay, you are going in a rocket in outer space. The rocket is the outer space, you are sitting in the rocket and sun is behind you. The sun is behind you. What will you see in the front? Will you see light or darkness in the front?
Darkness.
There will be not a single ray of light in the front. Even though you are standing just in front of the sun. Okay? The reason is simple. If you have to see the sunlight, the sunlight has to fall on some obstacle. And reflected light only you see. Okay. So the reflection of light in the space, there is not a single particle, not dust particle there. So that's why even people when they travel in the outer space, they see only darkness, pitch darkness. Are you clear? Understood. So, why I told this? Because that applies to consciousness. The consciousness of Chaitanyam is all pervading. Everywhere it is there. There is no place where it is not there. But it cannot be seen, it cannot be touched, it cannot be experienced by anybody. Because touch, sound, smell, taste, form. Rama, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, Sparsha. These are all belonging to sense organs. The Atma organ, Atma or self or consciousness cannot be, is not, you cannot get it from sense organs.
No form.
No form of any kind. So you can say it's invisible. Okay, what is visible is appearance in Atma. So now, the presence of Atma is known in the form of visible, like a reflection. Atma's presence is known when there is an obstacle. Like sunlight's presence is known when the obstacle is there, reflection is there. Like the presence of the Atma is known in the presence of an object. Because object consciousness develops. See, for example, the banana. I am seeing banana.
Yeah.
Right? So now, in the presence of banana, the consciousness is manifest as an object consciousness. Consciousness alone is reality. Okay, pure consciousness has no objects. The pure consciousness manifests as the body consciousness, the world consciousness, the subject consciousness and object consciousness when there is a obstacle to consciousness, when there is a reflecting media for the consciousness, right? So I have a subject consciousness. I see you are an object, you are object consciousness. Now I also realize that you are a subject consciousness. So the manifestation of consciousness can be experienced, whereas consciousness itself cannot be experienced. Understand? So the way the creation is there is for consciousness to experience itself. Your question is why I am there? The consciousness of God wants to experience the world. Like once in a while you go to movie, no? Yes. So consciousness is experiencing itself through you. Without you, there's no experience. Okay? The consciousness is silent and non-dual. But the moment an object comes into picture, there's experience. And the experience is consciousness only. There's no chair, there's a chair consciousness. There's no fan, there's a fan consciousness. We don't say it explicitly, but actually it's a consciousness only. There's nothing called matter. The consciousness is God, and all that is there is consciousness. And this consciousness is a satyam, means reality. The object is mithyam, unreality. So mithyam is required for satyam to
experience.
Satyam experiences itself in the form of mithyam.
Mithyam is maya.
Mithyam is unreal. Okay, what is unreal? I don't know whether I have done that. Real and unreal class I have done for you people. Satyam, mithyam.
Okay. So what about shakti?
Shakti is the expression. Appearance. Whatever appears is shakti only. Shakti, Shiva is pure
consciousness.
When Shiva appears as the world, it's Shakti. It's mithyam.
So the Shakti, Shiva consciousness is what?
Shiva becomes aware of himself by Shakti. Otherwise, she has no awareness. Silent and peaceful. Right? And the awareness, aware of himself, he has to be aware of himself only. That's nothing else. Right? There's nothing else. But it appears as a table. It appears as a chair. It is not a chair or a table, it's consciousness only. That's why it's mithya, not real, satya. In your dream, you saw a tiger, elephant. The tiger appears there, but it's not there. Right? So that appearance is your mind only. Like that, shakti only appears as everything. It's not permanent, it's not real. In a sense, it's not long-lasting. It's only mithyam. One who sees is satyam. Shiva experiences himself in the form of shakti. Expresses in the form of Shakti, experiences in the form of Shakti. Okay? Everything is Shiva and Shakti only. Okay? Is this analogy clear? Outer space and consciousness. Consciousness cannot know itself, consciousness doesn't know anything, it's just blissful. Blissful. It has no, it's not awareness also. It's not aware of anything, it's not aware of itself also. Only when there is mithya appears, it becomes aware of the itself and other.
The consciousness that is in the body, is that reflected consciousness or?
Reflected consciousness. This both reflected consciousness and original consciousness also is there, because original consciousness is always everywhere. But what you are experiencing in the body is reflected consciousness, Shakti. Okay. Have I taken the class on reflected consciousness? I'm taking it now. Is this clear? So this is the original consciousness, Shiva. Pure consciousness. Okay? It's called I. Denoted by I principle. So it's non-dual, there's no other, and it's not aware of anybody, it's not aware of itself also. Okay? It's like sun, no? If you ask sun, my dear sun, what is darkness? Sun will say, I don't know, because I've never seen. If you ask sun, what is light? Sun will say, I don't know, because he is the light. That is, the consciousness is not aware of anything, it's just awareness. It's not aware of anything. Okay. So that's called I. So when you say, I ate food, which I you are referring to? Huh?
Body.
You are referring to body. Okay, body, can it eat food without I?
No.
So, okay, but I doesn't eat food.
Yes.
I never eats food.
Yeah.
Okay, body eats food, but body cannot eat food without that I. So there's a mixing up happening. Okay, consciousness, which never eats anything, but when you speak of I, always you are referring to that I only. And always you are confused with body only. Anytime when you speak of I, you are always referring to Paramatma, which is not changing, it doesn't do anything, it's always there. This one. Okay? But when you say, I eat food, you are referring to body. Body cannot eat food without that I. I doesn't eat food. In between you make a claim that I eat food.
Who is claiming actually?
You only. I didn't claim. What did you say, Shana?
I experiences eating of food.
This I, it doesn't even know that there is a body. This I in the pure form doesn't even know there is a body. Okay? This I will tell you a next level of reality. The pure I has no, nothing else is possible in that. Right? There is no change possible, it's infinite. It's non-dual, it's pure, there's nothing there. If, for example, if you ask sun, sun, oh my dear sun, do you know darkness? He doesn't know darkness, because wherever the sunlight is, there's no darkness. Do you know sunlight? He doesn't know sunlight also, because everywhere it's there only. There's no other. This I doesn't even know your body exists. Okay? But, in a reflected consciousness, your body appears. It's like a dream-like state for the I, not real, original. I gets a dream. In that dream, Shashidhar is born. That dream is called Maya. Okay, so now this I, in pure form, there's nothing is possible for that way.
Yeah.
It doesn't even know that you exist, I exist, nobody, it doesn't even know it exists also. That's why it's not real. The moment it becomes, it knows it exists, then it gets trouble. It's blissful. Okay, that I gets a dream. In that dream, body comes into picture. The dream mind comes into picture first. So in the mind, the first reflection of I takes place. This I gets reflected as I am. Okay? Alright? So now that I am, you can feel, no? In your body, there's a I amness. Can you feel that I amness in your everybody? Right? That is called Shakti. This I am in Sanskrit is called Aham. Or a separation. It's called Shakti. Aham in Sanskrit means A to Z. In English, A to Z means what?
Everything.
Everything. In Sanskrit, in terms of saying A to Z, they said aham. Akara to hamkara.
Ahankara.
Aha, ahankara there. Adu shabda medisudi. Ahakara to hum. And A to Z, whatever is in the world is that I am. Okay? So now, if you go back to your I am in your body, you have gone to A to Z in the universe. How to go to it? Aham, aham, I amness in your body? How to go back?
Totality. Aham.
Are my dear, I keep on telling you, Sahaj Samadhi, go to I amness. Why are you making complicated things? Why are you bringing things which are not there? So go back to Sahaj Samadhi, stay in I amness. Then you have stayed with Shakti. Okay? That means in that I amness, there's no body, there's no me, there's no sun, moon. Everything has become one with that ahamness, I amness. You are one becoming one with totality. Now don't think that one becoming one with the totality, the sun, the moon, everything I am seeing, dot, nothing like that. Very good,
total,
I am.
Total silence.
Silence, no, samadhi.
No, yaar. I amness, the feeling of I amness is not total silence. Awareness is total silence. That's next level. Okay, sahaja samadhi, first step is stay in the I amness. When you stay in the I amness, you are staying in the totality. So then, when you say totality, there's no separation. You don't see sun, moon, and all. Okay, so that is called I amness. That sahaja samadhi, first step is go to I amness. The moment you go to the silence, you have gone to Shakti. Then you have become one with the totality. Okay? So the first reflection in your mind is called I amness, which is Shakti, Aham. And then there's a second reflection happens on the body. The body becomes alive now. The mind becomes alive first, intellect becomes alive first, then body becomes alive. Okay? So aliveness in your body, what you are feeling, is a secondary reflection of, that's called Chidabhasa, reflected consciousness. First reflection also Chidabhasa, second reflection also Chidabhasa. What, your body is alive, right? So your dead body will not be alive. Okay? So when you speak of Shiva, this is Shiva. So you are thinking, where is Shiva, where is Shiva, where is Shiva, Kailasa. Whole body is the consciousness in the body, right? Everything, every cell of the body has consciousness. That is Shiva. What are you searching Shiva? Where are you looking for Shiva? ಅಭಿಷೇಕ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು, ಪೂಜೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು, ನೈವೇದ್ಯ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು, ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೇ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು. ಓಕೆ, ಒಳಗಿರೋದೆಲ್ಲ ಶಿವನೇ. ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಶಿವ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಶಿವ ಗೋಸ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಶವ, ಡೆಡ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಸೈಲೆನ್ಸ್, ಪ್ಯೂರ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಡಿವೈನ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ಫಾದರ್, ಡಿವೈನ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಸದಾಶಿವ, ಪರಮೇಶ್ವರ, ಪರಬ್ರಹ್ಮ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ಬಾಡಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಲೈವ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಸಿ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ರೈಟ್? ಥ್ರೂ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಸಿ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಅ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಔಟ್ ದೇರ್? There is never a world out there. The world appears to be out there because of the Shakti's projection. Shakti. Okay. So there is never a world outside there. It in your dream, Paris appeared. The London appeared. Yeah. So what was there a Paris?
No.
Was there a London? So whatever world you are seeing is never there. It is a projection. It's a 7D projection. 7D projection I saw, I showed you last time?
No.
Last class, no, didn't see?
No.
It's a projection which is appearing in consciousness. Okay? How is it appearing? So the sound, sound is not coming. What? The sound is not there because I think that one projector is taking only the video. The audio portion is not taking.
It's not having a speaker, so it has to come from here.
No, this speaker is not
connected. Speaker should come from
here. Yeah, but then this guy is not, he is thinking that the speaker is there and he is giving, sending it to there.
No. Huh? You can.
Speaker is there. I have switched on the speaker. No, I have increased the volume. Volume is full. See, speaker is full.
There is some option to click on internal speaker.
How do you do that?
My laptop.
Or you have to switch on speaker on the projector.
How do you?
No, there is.
No, there, I don't think.
This one is not.
So, kya tha idea? Voice is low. ಇದು ಅವ್ರು ಕನ್ನಡಕ್ಕೆ ಹಾಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ವರ್ಚುವಲ್ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ವರ್ಚುವಲ್ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಕನ್ನಡಕ್ಕೆ ಹಾಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡಲ್ಲೇ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ಬಟ್ ದೇ ಅಪಿಯರ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೌನ್ ಆಲ್ ರೌಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಮೂವ್ ಆದಾಗ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಅನುಭವ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಹೇಳಿತ್ತು ಏನು ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡಲ್ಲೇ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಮೂವ್ ಆದಾಗ ಕಾಣ್ತದೆ ಕನ್ನಡಕ. Yeah.